In this tutorial, we're going to learn how to set a working directory in R. So what is a working directory? Well, a working directory is the location of a folder within a hierarchical file system. So commonly, we use our working directory folder to store the various data files that we might have for a specific project. And so what the working directory folder does is store files that then we can automatically reference. So it tells R where to find your data files, because ultimately we want to read or retrieve, in other words, the data from those data files and bring them in or import them into the R environment. So let's take a look and see how we do this. One of the best places to start is first to think about what our current working directory might be set as. And so we can use the getwd function to do this. So it's simply if we type into our console, which is this window down here that appears, and you'll see this little caret here and our cursor appears there, we can type in getwd. And if we just type that in with nothing in the parentheses, so we're just using the getwd function from base R, which stands for get working directory, and we hit enter or return, we can see what our current working directory is. Here, my current working directory is in a drive called the H drive, and then we see it's in the folder called R workshop. So this is one way to figure out where your current working directory is currently set. Now, if we want to change that working directory, it's rather simple to do that as well. So let's say that we want to change this working directory. Well, there's a couple ways that we can go about doing it. So one of the simplest ways is perhaps to go to the session, set working directory, and choose directory. And you can see here, or you could use the hotkeys, Control Shift H. Click on this. And then you can go into your normal file directory and select the folder where you would like to have your working directory set. And so again, this is the folder that you're probably downloading or depositing your data files into. Okay, and then you would click on this and open this and that would set it. Okay, now let's say that we want to set the working directory in another way. Well, some of you, as you get more comfortable with this, you might just go ahead and do this the old-fashioned or manual way. So using the setwd or set working directory function, followed by parentheses, and within those parentheses, typing in quotation marks, you could then type in the name of the working directory. So just for explanation purposes here, I will type in the exact name of that working directory folder that is in our H drive. It's our current one, so this is just gonna reset it. So here you see H drive / R workshop. And notice that R and W and R workshop are capitalized. And remember, R is case and space sensitive when you're naming these folders. So if we hit enter, you will see that we get the blue caret here, which means that everything worked. You can see set in our console here that we do have it set as our H drive R workshop subfolder there. And so where this is going is here. And so you can see that we have our, if we go to the H drive down here folder, and we take a look down here at the workshop folder, our workshop, this is where we have saved our working or set our working directory. And here you'll see various data files and things like that that I've deposited here. So in a Windows environment, if you click on this right here, you can see that path link. Now notice that Windows defaults to this, the slash being in this direction, whereas R is going to prefer the slash being in the other direction. So if you do come to the Windows environment and you wish to copy and paste this, so for instance, if we go copy, so highlight and copy and paste this, and you wanted to paste this into your working directory here. So I just did setwd function, and again, the double quotation marks within the parentheses. And then if I were to paste right here, notice how this slash is in the opposite direction. Well, that's going to be problematic. So you'll need to change it to this forward slash here so that it is in the proper format for R, and you could click enter and do it this way. Okay, so there you can type it directly into the console or you can set it in different ways. So let's look at it. Let's say that actually this isn't the working directory folder that I'd like to set. Well, I can then go to session, set working directory, choose working directory. And let's say that I know that it is in this folder, and this folder. So it's actually this working directory folder, this introduction to R folder, where I want to save all my data files and so forth. And this is also going to be where R will automatically save, unless you tell it otherwise, any type of files that you write out or export out of the R environment, such as plots and things like that, or data visualizations. And so here you can see the path extension here. Now you could copy and paste this in and then into your console there using the setwd function manually. However, what you'll find is that it might create more problems because then you'll have to manually switch the direction of those slashes. So what I prefer to do is just simply come here and click open. And note here how down in our console, it shows that we have set the working directory here. Okay, so setwd, and then this is our file extension or path directory here to our introduction to R folder, which is presumably where we're going to save all of our data files. So this is now our working directory. And this tells R where to find those files. Okay. Now, if we want to clear this console here, which sometimes we choose to do, let's say that we want to just clean this up. We don't care about the R version stuff that pops up here. We want to clear out all this. This doesn't get saved anyways, but one way to make it a little bit tidier when we're working in a given session is if you go to edit, and then go down to clear console, you can click on this, or you could do a control plus L. So control L can control it too, it can clear it if you have your console active. Okay, so we can clear it there. Now, what I prefer to do when setting a working directory is often you're gonna be working as part of a project or you want to maintain some kind of paper trail about where these files are saved, because someone might come after you and want to work with these data, but if they don't know what your working directory was, they might not be able to find it. So if you go to File, New File, you can open an R script. You can open a new R script window here, okay? Or which will correspond to an R script file. And so here, we could type in the name of the working directory, okay, using the setwd function again, and in double quotation marks within the parentheses. Let's say that we want to revert it back to that original folder, that R workshop folder in the H drive here, okay? Now, either leaving our cursor here or highlighting this line of text, we can then click run, and you'll see that we've set our working directory back to our H drive, R workshop folder here, okay? And then you could repeat this process. Let's say that you want to return it back to that other working directory that we had set. We can go to session, new set working directory and choose directory here. And let's go all the way back up. Go to workshops, find whatever folder. This is gonna be different for you likely. Almost certainly it'll be different for you. Find whatever folder you wanna save your data into. Here's mine's the introduction to R. I'm gonna click open. And notice how down here in our console, we see the output here. It doesn't appear in our R script. So what we can do to save this for future sessions, so we don't have to go through this process over and over again, we can just simply open up in R script and then run everything to get our working directory active or whichever one we choose. We can come down here, copy, and then paste here, okay? And so here you'll see that you can set this, it looks like it didn't quite get that last parentheses there, so make sure you have everything included there, because you want to have the opening and ending parenthesis here. And if I were to keep my cursor here or highlight this and click run, you will see that I have set the working directory there, and you'll see this reflected in the console window here as well. Now, as a good practice, it's often good to annotate this, which you can use the hashtag function and type to the right of it. So I'm going to say, let's set working directory for new project. And this is simply so that for myself or for others who come and work in this, they understand why I did this. You might even add in more information than this. Alternatively, you could add it over here. Anything that appears to the right of a hashtag or pound symbol can be a note. So you could type in note, 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 or whatever you want to put here. And what this does is this tells R that you don't run anything, that this is meaningless to R here. This is only meaningful to the human eyes that are gonna read this. Anything to the right of a hashtag is not gonna be meaningful for R, and it just says, don't try to run this. This is not a function or anything like that. Anything without a hashtag in front of it signals to R that this needs to be run. So again, in order to determine what your current working directory is, you can use that getwd function with nothing in the parentheses, no arguments in the parentheses, or you can use that setwd function to actually set your working directory, and as your single argument within quotation marks, list your file directory here, which is going to be where you're going to save your data files more than likely, and where R can export anything that you create in R to this folder automatically. You can always override this and you can always change this. It just makes things a little bit easier when you're working in R. So hopefully this clears up what setting a working directory means in R. This is really something we should start every session with, is making sure that we have the right working directory set. Thank you.